this is true again. Got two more word problems I'd like to take care of today. That deals with modeling with functions. I hope I didn't go too fast that second example in my previous video. I babbled on too much about why we care about word problems. So let's not do that and get right into this. I want to do two area problems where I'm going to relate the perimeter of the object to the area inside and show you how you can make a formula that relates those two, and so you have an equation with one variable. So let's take a look at the area of a rectangle. So I want to build a rectangle, maybe in a, you know, fence in a field or boxing, who cares, whatever. But I'm going to do something with a rectangular shape that has a perimeter equal to 1,000. Can I write a formula for the area of this rectangle that is only in terms of, say, x? Area in terms of just x. Well, first of all, and for this rectangle, the perimeter must be 1,000 units. Feet, miles, inches, yards, whatever it is you're putting around this rectangular area. Okay. All geometry questions, if they give you, and any math question, if they give you a piece of information that has a formula attached to it, you're going to use that formula. If they say the distance between two points is 15, then you're going to set up the distance formula. If they say the area of this triangle is equal to whatever, then you're going to set up the area of a triangle formula. So let's do that. We have perimeter. Now the perimeter is 1,000 feet, or inches, or miles, or just units. So the perimeter of an object, or rectangle, is 2L plus 2W. Or, I guess if we're going to do in terms of X or Y, I probably should use, you know, instead of L and W, let's just call it X and Y. Okay, so that's perimeter. And that's, you know, the two bottoms, well, might be the two X's, and the two sides is Y plus Y. So if you add all four sides up, you've got this perimeter formula. Now the perimeter, we're told, is supposed to be 1,000 units, 1,000 feet, 1,000 miles, 1,000 inches, whatever you're doing, whatever the word problem is about. But the perimeter has to be 1,000. Great. There's perimeter, and it's in the terms of two variables. But the question is not about making a formula for perimeter. The question is about finding an area formula. So how do you find the area of a rectangle? Well, that's length times width. So the area is length times width. Okay, great. Or because I'm using x's and y's, the area is x and y. Now, can I write a formula for area just in terms of x? Well, if all I'm doing is looking at area, then the answer is no. But if I have another piece of information that I have to relate the area to, I have to take the fact that perimeter is 1,000 and relate it or use that fixed value to help me find the area. We're not going to find the area of just any rectangle. We're going to find an area of a rectangle whose perimeter is 1,000. So we're relating those two values together. So because I want the perimeter set to be 1,000, I'm going to be allowed to write this, or I will be able to write this formula in terms of just one variable, using the information that the perimeter must be 1,000, not just any random rectangle. So I want it in terms of x. So I want the y to be gone. To do that, I'm going to take my first equation and solve it for y, so I can use it to then plug into the other equation. So let's see what that looks like, shall we? Let's take the perimeter, and we're going to solve it for y, so I'm going to subtract both sides by 2x, and unfortunately did not leave myself room to go down, so I'm going to go this way. So 1,000 minus 2x, that would be 100. 1,000 minus 2x is equal to 2y, and now I'm going to divide everything by 2, and get y is equal to 1,000 minus 2x. Now, if you're really comfortable with your algebra, you already know this is going to be 500 minus x. I'm going to show that because some of my kids are, you know, occasionally they'll mess up on the cancellation or reduction process. Both of these terms have a factor of 2. So if I divide out that factor of 2, it's going to be 500 minus x over 2 equals y. And now, of course, like you might have seen already, the 2's are going to cancel out. So y equals 500 minus x. that is going to go into the other equation, the equation for area that I actually care about, or one in my final answer. So my area in terms of x, now I can write it in function notation because it's only going to be in terms of x, not x and y, is x, let's say the original width, times y, maybe it's the height, who cares, it's multiplication, it's commutative, but the y is going to come out and it's going to go 500 minus x is going to go in its place. So now I went from an area of just any regular random rectangle to the area of a rectangle whose perimeter has been set to be 1,000. Pretty neat. And what I can do is, if I clean this up a little bit more, my students are not doing this, but your class might be at this point. Now I can write the area of a rectangle whose perimeter is set to be 1,000, clean it up, and look at this. Just like the previous video, we have an exponent of 2, which means parabola, and it's opening down. You know what that means? That means that if you were extending this a little bit farther, you could let x be the x-axis, the y-axis be the area. You could graph that parabola on your graphing calculator. Oh, this will be the labs. This is going to be one of the labs I show very soon, is how to find relative max and mins with a TI-83 or 84. I can graph that parabola on my calculator, and if I find the top of the parabola, if I find the vertex, I'm also going to find what length of x is going to maximize the area of the rectangle. So if you wanted to enclose the maximum amount of area with the least amount of, say, fencing, if this were a field, then you would know what dimensions to make that field to maximize the area inside with the least amount of perimeter. Bam! Woo! Area compared to perimeter for a simple rectangle. There you go. Take it down if you need it. All right. Let's do one more example, and I think that's going to be time. I'm going to run back here and check real quick because I forgot to look at the clock. Okay, I've got 7 minutes, so that was half the time, and here's the other half. Same kind of question, area related to perimeter, only this time we're building like an oval track. Oh, that's a terrible drawing, but we're going to build like a cross-country track. And cross-country tracks have two straight sections in them, and then they have some half circles on the side. And let's say that the perimeter of this track, if this were a textbook, I'd be able to show all the lanes and make this all perfect, but we're just going to do the very inside of this track. And the perimeter of this object, the perimeter of this track, we're going to set up to be 500 meters. I have no idea if that's appropriate length for a cross-country track. I'm sure it's not. But the perimeter of this geometric figure is 500 meters. Can I write the area of this track such that the area is in terms of R? Can I write the area just with the radius that is going to make up these two half circles of the track? Because the area will change. If I make the track really, really long and skinny, I can actually have very little to no area inside the track. Or maybe I can make the straight sides really short and just maximize the semicircles, basically just scrunch it together until I have a perfect circle, which would probably be the most efficient shape and hold the most area inside. So, well, let's see. We have to have some straight sections, so let's call those x. And, of course, we're going to have a radius. Radiuses go from the center of a circle to the outside, and this is only a half circle, but it's defined as a semicircle. Well, let's start with perimeter, because we know what perimeter is. We want the perimeter to be 500 meters. All right, so 500 meters, the perimeter. How do you find the perimeter of this object? Well, if I start here, I have to go x, and then I'm going to come back a distance of x. So the perimeter is going to be made up of x plus x, or 2x. Well, now that's the two straight sides. What about the semicircles on the ends of it? If I take out the center and I squish together these ends, I'm going to have a circle. Well, how do you find the perimeter or the circumference of a circle? 2 pi r. So we're going to have the perimeter, the entire length, I want 500 meters. That's going to be made up of the two straight sides plus 2 pi r. That's going to be the circumference of the two half circles, or if you put the two half circles together, the circumference of the circle of the two ends of the track. Perfect. Perimeter. Now, I want an area formula, not a perimeter formula. And I want the area formula to only be in terms of r. So how would you find the area of this, it's not oval, but of this sort of ovalish track with the straight section in the middle? Well, the area, the inside of this is made up of a rectangle, which is length times width. So x times 2r. And then that's the rectangle in the middle. Now how do you find the area of a circle? Well, that's pi r squared. Again, remember the circle or the two half circles or the two semicircles that would come together if you took out the middle section. Now we have the area of this track, this cross and field track. Well, I don't want the area of any track. I want the area of a track whose perimeter is held steady at 500 meters. Now I'm going to relate together the fixed perimeter and the non-fixed area, because it's non-fixed because we can change the radius, we can change the shape of the track. And we're going to relate these together. So that means that I'm going to be allowed with this fixed perimeter of 500 to solve this for x, so I can plug that answer into this formula and have it only in terms of r. So let's solve this for x. That means we're going to move the 2 pi over with subtraction. So again, I didn't leave myself room like the last example, so we'll go in this direction. We're going to have 500 minus 2 pi r equals 2x. And again, I want to solve for x. I'm going to divide everything by 2. I'm not going to be quite as thorough with showing the cancellation here because I just did a minute ago. 500 divided by 2 is 250. And 2 pi r divided by 2, or 2 divided by 2, is 1. So minus pi r. Ah, now, with my fixed perimeter 500, x equals 250 minus pi r. So where this x is, this will go. So area, in terms of now I can say r, is 2 times 250 minus pi r. That's this x times r plus pi r squared. And that's going to be 250 times 2 is 500 minus 2 pi r times r plus pi r squared. Multiply that through, we get 500 r minus 2 pi r squared plus pi r squared. And last time I checked, negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. So 500 r minus pi r squared equals the area. Once again, we have a squared term. Leading coefficient is negative. So if, again, you wanted to maximize the area inside this track, you could graph that downward opening parabola and find the perfect radius to maximize the area inside of your track. We, however, in my class, are not going that far, but you with your graphing calculator can. Bam! Thank you for watching. Woo!